a white belt for Amoli. Why can't I learn karate too, like Sudhir?
Because you're a girl, that's why. Everyone knows karate is for boys.
It's for everyone. Why can't I learn it too? I bet I'll be good at it too. Perhaps even better than you are if I'm just given a chance.
But you won't get a chance.
Karate is only for boys. Yes, karate is only for boys. However, she was not willing to give up easily. After thinking hard, she came up with a plan. I want to come along with you too. If you let me watch your karate class, I'll do your homework daily. I'll even lend you a bit of my pocket money.
Okay, but my master must never see you. And make sure that father and mother don't find out about this.
Amoli watched carefully the real karate exercises. A series of quick, sharp punches and kicks, accompanied by the karate cry. Within a few weeks, she could identify some of the exercises that the students performed. One evening, Amoli and her mother were walking home from a neighbor's house. A man on a bicycle suddenly grabbed mother's handbag. She screamed, but held onto the bag. Amoli, quick as lightning, was beside the man in a flash. Her fist flew out and hit the man's chest as she uttered a loud karate cry. The man was so astonished that he let go of the handbag. He was surrounded by an angry crowd. The thief was punched and marched to the police station.
Well done, young lady. We need more brave girls like you to teach such thieves a lesson. You must be so proud of your brave daughter, who is truly a karate champion. It's so good that you encouraged her to take up such a useful sport.
That night, Amoli's parents decided to enroll her in Sudhir's karate class.